Hey, happy Sunday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I'm going to give you a huge update on what's going on with our whole weather pattern because the number for today is 2. We have 2 cold fronts coming down, bringing severe weather 2 different times. We have chances for major snow to come with that as well. We have 2 tropical systems forming up. It's going to be Patty and Raphael, and potentially a second cold blast that could come down and block Patty from coming any further towards the west. But I'm going to show you the latest information in this video. That way you know what the timing is and what to expect. Now, if you've never been here before, I do have links down below in the description to help save you time. If you have time, watch it all the way through or come back and see when you do have time. But make sure you hit that share button or even that like button and help other people see this information, because it's not just one system, one storm forming. Everything is going to double up. It's going to be 2 of everything. But you can see here from your 500 millibar vorticity that as you go past Monday into Tuesday. It's Tuesday that starts bringing your severe weather in front of this system coming through, and as you go into Wednesday, bringing more storms, showing a lot of strength for northern Missouri and eastern Iowa, especially as you go into Wednesday, showing that some of the strongest weather so far out of the system. But we have a second one next week when we get another one coming through, while we get potentially 2 systems still forming up in the Caribbean. Euro and GFS have seen the same thing. Only difference is Euro is putting these systems together and building as one. But you can see we do have severe weather coming in for next week as well. So we got 2 of everything. Showing you lightning strikes as you go into Tuesday, bringing you severe storms all the way from the Texas Panhandle through southern Minnesota. There's chances for hail to come with these lightning strikes also. But you can see as you go into Wednesday, it's a little bit stronger, chances for larger hail to happen all the way from Oklahoma. See this? Going all the way into Wednesday evening, bringing you chances for large hail to come with that. Next 5 days, when that storm system comes in, it's bringing 40 miles per hour wind gusts and 50s over here for Oklahoma and for Kansas, higher elevations of New Mexico and Colorado. When you look with GFS, GFS sees it stronger when you look at it. Look, you get a whole line of 50 miles per hour plus 50, 55, high 50s. You get to 60s in the red. Stronger damaging winds coming with it. So when you go by a third model, try and get a trend. You can see with the Canadian trending, it is going to be stronger winds than just 40. Those are bringing the 50s and even the high 50s at that, maybe low 60s. Now, this is also bringing major snow with it. Looks like the heavier snow is of course in the higher elevations, but anywhere in that blue is anywhere from 5 to 7 inches of snowfall. You get all the way up towards 10 inches in the purple and a foot towards the pink. When you go to Euro, it don't show a whole bunch over here for the Dakotas and Minnesota. You can see this with the Canadian as well. It's very light amount. Maybe northern Minnesota and the UP of Michigan getting some snow, but a lot of this is going to be in the Canada, the higher elevations of the Rockies and the Northwest. Showing that as you go into Tuesday, you do have a 5% risk for severe weather for those storms. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for that severe weather. Showing that the environment will bring chances for hail and the storms in the front of it, it will bring chances for your wind gusts, severe wind gusts. But the severe weather will go down quickly because this goes later in the afternoon into the overnight hours where it loses its chance to stay severe and is less favorable. This will be localized and marginal. And as you go through day 4, on Wednesday, you do have a chance for severe weather. So far, here's your cities and states at risk. Showing that it is stronger with GFS, but not as strong with the Euro. So they have it as if this environment can materialize, supercell development with large hail and severe wind gusts could occur. A chance for very large hail will be possible with the more intense cells, and an isolated tornado threat also appears possible. Then after you deal with this pattern with this cold air, severe storms, the major snow, then we're going to have the pattern come right back again from Monday and on for next week and bringing you chances for multiple systems to form. Now this is when we have strong lift passing through, and it helps get our thunderstorms roaring all the way from pretty much now, but literally going from the 31st of October and into November. Very strong lift passing through, helping storms bubble up and create a lot of convection. Right now, National Hurricane Center does have the one section, but I still believe we're going to get a second section right here coming up shortly from National Hurricane Center for two storms. But for the first one, you can see that it's at 30% chance for something to form up. Nothing in the next 48 hours. This is going to take a while. When this cold front comes through, it's going to suppress all these thunderstorms down to the south. That's where the second one is going to form up. Then the first one's going to come back later after that, in between the first and the second cold front. And you can still see this here from Global Tropics, that better chance of Patty to form up. Now this is going to be suppressed down on this cold front, and then we're going to get this one squeezed out. So we are going to get two storms and potentially still have more lift in the area after we deal with these two. So and literally it has a chance for Patty to form in 5 days, but then we're going to get that second section start to form up by the Bahamas. That's going to be our second storm. It's going to be Raphael. Then all this is going to start moving north about 7 or 8 days. Now you can see this when you look at the increments. So you look at 6, 7 days. Now you're getting Patty starting to form up by Central America. While you start to get a better advantage of that front, you get some convection and you're getting a system forming over by Puerto Rico going towards the Bahamas. Now as you go 8, 9 days, that's where this one potentially goes to the east, but this is where Patty makes his north push towards Jamaica as you go towards the very beginning of November. Then as you go 10, 11 days, you can see it just all starts drifting back to the west, where it could go back to the Western Caribbean, then do that hook. It all depends if that cold front comes through. If that front comes through, that second one, it would help this go back to the east. If that second front does not come through and it's a weaker front, it will allow this to go further to the north. Also showing on the latest update on our deep ocean heat content that the deep ocean heat is getting stronger and stronger. Look at that. That is a lot of heat for the storm system to tap into. Look at it over here by Jamaica as well. So as it starts bottling up with that cold front and it gets shoved down to the south, when it starts headed north, it has a lot of heat to tap into and help it grow. And you still have a lot of heat in the Caribbean, period. A lot of above average warm temperatures in the Caribbean. Now you can see it's below average over here because we've been having a lot of strong storms as it is. But when you get to 80 degrees Fahrenheit, this is where it can sustain itself. Now, when you get a little bit away from that bright yellow to that darker yellow orange color, that's 80, and everything red and above is higher temperatures. And showing on the latest update that we have a lot of convection building, a lot of favorable environment passing through right into our region, and we're going into multiple systems all the way into November. And it's not just the GFS seeing this. You can see this also with the Euro. We have multiple systems coming into our direction end of October, beginning of November. I've been saying this for a long time. So it is trending now and seen by both. You can see by the ensembles, this right here is by the Euro, that we have a chance literally in 7, 8 days for a system to form up over here by Puerto Rico, also over here in Central America, and get two systems trending that. That one would be Raphael, whichever one it would be. The one over here by the Caribbean, by Bahamas, is trending to go further towards the east, but it could get blocked and stay there for a little bit while we get the second one, while we get that Patty that goes to the west. That is the trend on all the ensembles when you look at them. You can see this with GFS as well. Both systems forming up. Maybe going out to the east with the second one, and then that other one going to the west. When you look like by the Canadian, you can see almost the same thing. The Canadian is showing a very weak chance for that one to form up by Puerto Rico and the Bahamas, but it sees that westward shift on what forms up by Central America, and that's concerning. So the latest runs, the 0Z with GFS shows that we'll get both of them by the time we go through Sunday, and then that's going towards east, affecting no one in United States potentially, but affecting multiple people. You still got to watch out for Jamaica, still got to watch out for Hispaniola, still got to watch out for the Caribbean over by Bahamas, showing it could be a lot of people still getting impacted by a strong system. Now when you go by the 60, this one just come out this morning, showing we are going to get it in about 6 days, maybe 7 days, two systems forming up and showing some pretty strong systems, especially what's over here by Jamaica. That's pretty concerning, Jamaica. So please pay attention to these systems. And look, maybe they can both get pushed out if we get that second cold front. So I will show you about the latest information. When you go by the Euro shows that it would be a weaker, more like a tropical wave on that second one. But you can see them both maybe getting together and then weaken off. Look at that. Not much from the Euro. But the Canadian is agreeing that second one, not much on that first one, could just be a very weak tropical depression, just a group of disorganized thunderstorms. But showing that second one does have a good chance to strengthen up. Now, if this cold front comes down, whether it's strong or weak makes a difference. If it's strong, it'll push it out. If it's weak, it's going to come down and go out and leave all that wide open. So the latest on GFS shows that a cold air will come all the way down by the time you come to the 6th and the 7th. Through the 8th. Very cold temperatures, very cold wind chills. I don't want to show you those yet. That's still a few days down the road, and it might not happen. Because when you look for the chance for a cold blast, for deeper cold air to come in, you can see all the way from the 6th through the 8th that GFS is seeing a dip coming through. Now, when you look at this with the Euro, it's not seeing it. So whether that's going to be there and block the strongest one, if there is two, which would be the one in Central America, whether it's going to be there to block that or not is still too far down the road to know for sure. Matter of fact, if you go by the latest ensembles, you can see in multiple ensembles that it is showing that that could go potentially to the Gulf. You see that going right into the Gulf? It could potentially go to the Gulf. Now, thankfully, we go by this right here. This is your control member. This is your more likely outcome. And so far showing that we still could get two systems, but both of them would be weak. And maybe a weak system on Hispaniola. And that would be it. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope this helps you understand what pattern we're going into. Not just for this week, for next week also. We're going to have two of everything coming now. In the tropics, I still think we could get two, but one will be weak, but the other one will be stronger. I appreciate every single one of y'all. Please help me share this information to other people, because there's going to be multiple stories coming out of this pattern, but the whole pattern in general is what we just looked at, and it looks like a lot is going on for the next 2 weeks. The weather is just about to be crazy for a couple of weeks. Now, before I go, Isaiah 42:5-8. Thus saith God the Lord, he that created the heavens and stretched them out, he that spread forth the earth and that which cometh out of it, he that giveth breath unto the people upon it and spirit to them that walk therein. I, the Lord, have called thee in righteousness and will hold thine hand and will keep thee and give thee for a covenant of the people, for a light of the Gentiles, to open the blind eyes, to bring out the prisoners from the prison, and them that sit in darkness out of the prison house. I am the Lord, that is my name, and my glory will I not give to another, neither my praise to graven images. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you again for tomorrow morning. Updates will be starting shortly. Remember, when you wear the cross, don't wear it with Jesus on the cross. That's a graven image. He's not on that cross anymore. He's up in heaven in his glory. Amen. So wear accordingly so you don't get yourself in trouble not knowingly, because now you know. So make sure you do it correctly. I used to wear one myself a long time ago, and I corrected myself. Please don't wear no graven images. Our Father really don't like that. Hope you have a great day, though. And remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you in the morning.